I'm joined by Nick Swierzy from Ooredoo, Myanmar. Nick, can you give us an update on how things are progressing towards your commercial launch?
Really well, actually. It's certainly not without challenges. We're building everything from the ground up. So everything from the very basic infrastructure to the training of our national employees, all the way through to working with the relevant authorities on how we actually go out and build the networks. That's something that's never been done before in a commercial sense. So to that extent, the challenge is building capacity while we build a network.
Okay, so what sort of coverage are you looking at when you launch?
Well, as much as we can get. That's obviously a moving target. So we will endeavor to have the three major cities, which is Yangon, Mandalay, and Naypyidaw, as well as the corridors connecting them to be covered at launch. And as we've said earlier, we expect to launch commercially in the third quarter.
Okay, so how much of a challenge is it rolling out a network in a country where a lot of the other infrastructure, things like power, roads, is kind of not in place?
It forces innovation. So we've never rolled out in a country where we've had these different challenges. And I think that's what actually got our bid noticed, because we looked at things differently and we looked at how we can bring power to a lot of places. But it's not about bringing power just to the base station, it's also how will people power their phones. And so we've looked at models around the world as to how we can bring community power in, but also how we can share the power solutions with our competitors as well.
Okay, so you've mentioned sharing power with competitors. I mean, is infrastructure sharing something that you think could be important in the market?
It's going to be very important. I think we've got a unique opportunity with our competitors to get sharing right from the beginning, where almost everywhere else in the world we've looked at sharing retrospectively, which is very difficult to put the jigsaw puzzle together. Largely two or three operators rolling out very similar coverage on a demographic heat map will have very similar infrastructure needs. So we are, to the extent we can, working with our partners and with the other operators, I guess, to share what it is we can share.
Okay, so you've mentioned obviously there's going to be another big launch this year.
Yes.
I mean, how are you going to look to differentiate when you reach the market?
So our network's actually a little bit different. We're doing all 3G. We've never done that before, but we saw the opportunity, and again back to the challenge from the union government, which was to leapfrog other countries in ASEAN. So we decided to bid an all 3G bid, and so we will have 3G internet everywhere that we launch and everywhere in the country. So in 5 years' time, that'll cover 97% of the population. And I think in the first instance, it's about providing great product and service, but also it's all of those pieces that you can add onto the sides of having an all data network that we think will make it a very interesting proposition.
So how do you kind of educate customers when you are launching kind of an advanced network into a market where teledensity is quite low?
Yeah, no, I mean, again, great question, great challenge. In the cities, it's probably not such an issue, because there is, surprisingly, you see more smartphones, but you know, again, that's a very limited demographic that have the smartphones and the 3G access from the incumbent today. As we roll out into the rural areas and really the hinterland, we as part of our bid committed to build telecommunity centers, and these will be centers that provide on a CSR basis some mobile education, some mobile health applications. And actually it'll be getting these grassroots programs going that will actually help educate the communities as to what benefits the services we bring will offer.
Okay, so do you think there's going to be a big opportunity to launch things like health, money,
absolutely,
kind of from the outset?
Absolutely. And I think that's where we see the opportunity in taking this beyond the traditional talk and text model and looking at what it is we can do as a next generation model to say it's all 3G, future ready for LTE as and when that's available. But we think we can get the people of Myanmar advanced services today and get them using advanced services much more quickly than we've seen in other markets.
Okay, but how do you balance the need obviously to invest a lot in the network in a market where ARPU is going to be low?
The challenge is building enough quickly enough in the beginning. And so we've got 6 or 7% teledensity today. This is today a case of if you build it, they will come. As we move up the penetration curve, of course, we'll always be careful on what we spend and how we allocate that investment. But this again comes back to the earlier question of how are we going to share and what is it we're going to share? And our sense is if it's made of steel or concrete, that's something that we should be sharing. It's not strategic. And so we are in very active discussions with all of the relevant parties to ensure that the cost model matches the kind of country revenue model, if you will. And that's also why we committed to be a very national-centric company with over 99% nationals at the end of year five. So again, the cost structure of the business will match the revenue that we expect to get, but sharing is important. A very national workforce is important, which is also part of our piece of really a small bit of nation building for the country as it opens up to the League of Nations.
Okay, there were some reports fairly recently that there's been some local opposition on religious grounds, kind of all things. I mean, how do you kind of counter that kind of argument when you launch?
This is something that you see in a lot of places, and it comes from a very narrow part of the community. So it may get over-indexed in terms of the airtime it gets as opposed to what the grassroots support is. At the end of it, we're a company that is here to provide great services, and we think our service and product offering will overcome any questions about where the company's originated from. Certainly, there's lots of companies that come from different places with lots of different international shareholdings, and I think that this can be misinterpreted, but we present ourselves as a professional company, and we're here to provide great services to the people of Myanmar.
Excellent. So thanks very much for your time.
Thank you.